non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. Here's what to do. Hi, I'm Dr. Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com, and this is Chris Masterjohn Lite, where the name of the game is details, schmeetails. Just tell me what works. And today we're going to talk about non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, a topic that I've done a lot of research on because when I did my PhD, my laboratory specialized in this particular condition, and I actually have some papers on it. So non-alcoholic fatty liver disease afflicts an estimated 70 million Americans, and it's especially common in obesity and overweight and in both type 1 and type 2 diabetes. The only way to diagnose it is with ultrasound or a more advanced imaging technique. Ultrasound is the least invasive. Liver enzymes are not useful in diagnosing it. And if you're not going to get an ultrasound, then or a more advanced imaging technique, then it makes more sense to assume you have fatty liver if you are obese or have diabetes than to assume you don't, simply because the probability is that high. So if we have fatty liver, what are we going to do about it? I believe the foundation for most cases should be what I would call a choline-boosting modified fast. And I'm borrowing this name from a concept that this is very loosely based on, called a protein-sparing modified fast, where the idea is to have a strict restriction of calories while providing protein, vitamins, and minerals to prevent muscle wasting. In this case, we absolutely do want to cause as much weight loss as we can get away with causing, but we want to focus not so much on muscle wasting, but we want to focus on providing a lot of choline, whether in the diet or that you synthesize within your liver, because choline is the primary, most important factor for getting fat out of the liver. The basic principles involved here are assuming that fatty liver is all about a fat in versus fat out equation. The factors that influence fat into the liver are free fatty acids that are circulating in your blood, especially free fatty acids that are derived from the visceral abdominal fat pad, because your visceral abdominal fat empties free fatty acids directly into your liver. Fat can also wind up in your liver because of the food that you eat. Out of the possible foods that you could eat, fat is the thing that is most likely to contribute fat going into the liver. This should be reduced the most. The second most likely thing to generate liver fat is fructose. There's fructose in any form of sugar, whether you're talking about table sugar or you're talking about high fructose corn syrup that's in your sodas. All of that sugary stuff is a lot more likely to contribute to liver fat than protein or starch, even though fat is more likely to contribute to liver fat even than fructose. So what we're trying to do is we're especially targeting fat and we're especially targeting fructose, and then we want to make most of the diet be protein and starch. In terms of protein and starch, the protein is most important because the protein is not only helping you preserve your lean mass while you're losing weight, but the protein is also helping you make choline. Choline is the principal thing that gets fat out of your liver. Any protein will help you make your own choline, but animal protein is about twice as good at helping you make protein as plant protein is. Additionally, to make your own choline and to help preserve the choline that does come into your diet, we want a lot of vitamin B12 and folate. Then we also want just lots of choline coming into the diet as well. The starch is basically filling the calories that are left over. And how much starch should be included in the diet is largely going to be determined by to what degree do you need to cut your calories. The last principle that we want to incorporate is we want antioxidant protection. And that's because oxidative stress or oxidative damage in the liver can actually hurt the ability of the liver to export fat. And it doesn't matter how much choline we're getting in to help us export fat. If that process is being damaged by oxidative stress, it's not going to work properly. So what would a diet look like that would achieve this? Well, I think for protein, you want to focus on lean animal proteins, and you want to get 1 gram of protein for every pound of body weight. And you can roughly double that if you measure your weight in kilograms. Although you want most of that protein coming in the form of lean protein, I would include 3 or 4 eggs a day because they're a very rich source of choline. I would also include 1 or 2 servings of liver per week for the same reason. That liver is also an excellent source of vitamin B12 and folate. And if you really hate the taste of liver, then I would use a high quality liver supplement. For example, the ancestral liver capsules that I advertise in this show, 6 to 9 of those a day would be a great source of the nutrients that we've just been discussing. In most cases, the person with fatty liver is going to have a lot of weight to lose. If you're going to pursue a rapid weight loss approach, then I would recommend getting 3 to 6 cups of dark green vegetables a day, and primarily as steamed or raw vegetables. And that's going to contribute a lot of folate. And it's also going to take up a lot of volume. As long as the person can handle it without GI problems, then it goes a long way towards filling up the plate. After that, I would provide most of the rest of the volume of food as low-calorie, low-carbohydrate vegetables without added fats. Many factors are going to influence someone's ability to adhere to strict caloric restriction. And so for someone who can't handle the level of caloric restriction, or for someone who's fairly close to their ideal weight, then it makes sense to replace some of those vegetables with starches. In particular, reducing the dark green vegetables and replacing them with legumes is a great way to maintain high levels of folate in the diet. For someone who cannot handle the digestion of greens or legumes, then the best thing to include is starches that they can digest. In that case, you want to make sure that you're providing supplements of methylfolate to replace the loss of the primary food sources in the diet. For a person who cannot handle the digestion of the greens and the legumes, and who cannot handle the carbohydrate load of the starch due to blood sugar problems, then I do think that it is advisable to include sources of fat that round out the calorie needs of that person. It's just that fat isn't the ideal choice to do that from the perspective of fatty liver. At the end of the day, the final calorie intake needs to be adjusted according to what is a sustainable degree of weight loss that the person can handle. If the person is very close to their ideal weight, which is not the usual case in fatty liver, then they shouldn't be on a very steep caloric deficit. If the person psychologically doesn't do well with a very steep caloric deficit, then you need to round it out to what they can handle. But this is going to be a balance of, is the person motivated by the rapid fat loss to continue with the rapid fat loss and achieve the goal quickly? Or is that person so burdened by the rapid fat loss that they need something more moderate? In that case, you round out the calories. Again, the top choice is going to be with greens and legumes, where the legumes are the main source of extra calories. And then you go down the ladder to other starches and to fats on an as-needed basis, depending on what that person can handle digestively and metabolically. This episode is brought to you by Ancestral Supplements Living Collagen. Our Native American ancestors believed that eating the organs from a healthy animal would support the health of the corresponding organ of the individual. Ancestral Supplements has a nose-to-tail product line of grass-fed liver, organs, living collagen, bone marrow, and more, all in the convenience of a capsule. For more information or to buy any of their products, go to ancestralsupplements.com. This episode is brought to you by Ample. Ample is a meal in a bottle that takes a total of 2 minutes to prepare, consume, and clean up. It provides a balance of fat, protein, and carbs, plus all the vitamins and minerals you need in a single meal, all from a blend of natural ingredients. It's available in original, vegan, and keto versions, portioned as either 400 or 600 calories per meal. I'm an advisor to Ample, and I use it to save time when I'm working on major projects on a tight schedule. It keeps my brain going while I power through the day, never letting food prep get in the way of my productivity. Head to amplemeal.com and enter the promo code CHRIS15 at checkout for a 15% discount off your first order. For ad-free versions of these episodes with transcripts that you can read and getting early access to the episodes, often weeks or maybe even months ahead of time, you can sign up for the CMJ Masterpass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass
and use the code LIGHT10 to get 10% lifetime discount. The audio of this episode was enhanced and post-processed by Bob Devodian of Torian Mixing. You can find more of his work at torianonlinemixing.com.
All right, I hope you found this useful. Signing off, this is Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com. This is Chris Masterjohn Light, and I will see you in the next episode.